Fourth one, ideal gas equation. Ideal gas equation and absolute temperature or zero temperature. Absolute zero. So ideal gas. Okay, see what I said. First we will see about the gas. The gas contain, the gas is contain total molecules. I said the matter is matter can be divided into solid, liquid, gas. So the gas total is made by the particles. So how the particle arrangement will be there in the gas? So how arrangement will be there? The particles are very near or far distance in the gas. Gas means the particle arrangement will be very long distance will be there. As soon as given, suppose let us take best example, take the balloon and fill it, blow it and tie with. Then what happen inside? What inside? What is there? Gas will be filled. So for that, now we are going to derive that ideal gas equation. So before you should know, before going to derive the ideal gas equation, you should know about pressure. Next one is volume. Next one is temperature. You should understand these three parameters. Then we can derive the ideal gas equations. Okay, what is the first one? P letter will be there. Next one, second, V letter will be there. Next, third one is T. Okay, P means pressure, V means volume, and T means temperature. Okay, already I said in the previous class, pressure. What is the pressure? Force by area. Then we can say that is the pressure. Next, volume. Okay, suppose if you want to measure the volume, what we can do? Simply we have to multiply the length into breadth into height, then we can measure. Next, what is the next one? Value means here which volume you are taking. Suppose you are consider, you are filling gas inside the balloon, then you are considering that volume. Next, pressure means suppose you are applying some pressure, okay, 20 pascal or 30 pressure, we are pressure measurement is pascal. Okay, we are applying some pressure on that object, then it is sometime it may be sometime it may be expand, sometime it may be contract. So this is last one is temperature. You know the temperature, just now I said about the hotness or coldness, the degree of hotness or coldness, we are calling that is the temperature. So now we are going to deal with these three parameters. Okay, before going to derive the this ideal gas equations, we are having some laws. Okay, in general, especially in the thermal properties of matter, we can study two laws. One is first one, we can say that is the Boyle's law. Next one we can say Charles law. You might have studied these laws in the, I think, 9th class. So what is the Charles law, what is the Boyle's law? Now we are going to, now I am going to define the first one is Boyle's law. Okay, in the Boyle's law also, in the Charles law also, only three parameters will be exist. First one is temperature, next second one is volume, next third one is pressure. So the Boyle's law deals, in the Boyle's law you have to keep the temperature constant, then remaining will be, you can, remaining will be change. So now I am going to give the definition of Boyle's law. Next, Boyle's law. Okay, what is the Boyle's law? At constant temperature, pressure of the gas. At constant temperature, pressure of the gas is So what is the Boyle's law? At constant temperature, pressure of the gas is inversely proportional to the volume of the gas. Why I have taken here gas means, what is our heading? Ideal gas. So we have to consider here gas. We should not consider here liquid gas. There is no ideal liquid equation. Only we are having the ideal gas equation. Why? Because if you are having liquid, if you give the more heat, then what happen? That will coming into boil. Then what happens automatically? It is evaporating. Evaporating means, evaporation means nothing but what we can say, that is gas. That's why we are going to derive the ideal gas equations. So boils, boils means scientist name. What he said? At constant temperature, keep the temperature constant. Then what happened? Pressure is inversely proportional to, inversely proportional to volume. Then what we can write? At T means at constant T. Then what happened? P, inversely proportional to volume. Then what we can have? Pre-proportional 1 by V. Then what we can write? If you remove the proportional, then we can write one constant. Then what happened? K by V. Then PV is equal to what we can write? K. Then PV is equal to constant. Okay, this is the Boyle's law. So what is the Boyle's law? PV is equal to, if we are able to prove that PV is equal to constant, then we can say that is the Boyle's law. So remember this statement. Based on this, we are going to solve the problems.